high tide, friends, and you know what that means. That means it's time to go float some boats. Check out the world map, everyone. We absolutely love this Lego set, and we are right here on the coast of Maine in the United States. And yes, we are gonna go outside and put on our big green rubber boots. We're gonna go in the ocean and we are gonna float some boats. Hey, Roxy girl, what's daddy doing over there? What are you doing? You just sitting and chilling? You're chilling like a villain at the ocean? All right, so guys, when in Maine, and you're gonna go do a boat float test, the first thing you need to do are put on these gigantic boots called hip waders, because if you lose your boats, you're gonna have to go after them, and the water is cold, and it's very wet. The ocean is very wet, my friends, just a little. So we learned when we were up here, when we first purchased the house, that you needed these things called hip waders if you really wanted to go out and do like clamming, walking through the water, walking through the mud flats kind of thing. So these are gigantic boots that actually go all the way up to your hips. They are pretty attractive, but this is what a real Mainer looks like when they're going out on the ocean. Hey friends, Sarah here. Welcome back to another video. And today's video is the epic boat float. And we are actually going to take these boats down to the ocean. So we're not gonna float them in a wading pool. We're not gonna float them in a bathtub. We are gonna see how they float in the actual ocean. We're gonna get our big boots on. We're gonna gather our boats and we're gonna head down. I think we're actually only going to take 3 of these though. And we're gonna start with the Technic catamaran. We're gonna go down with the big harbor vessel. And then I think we're gonna take down this little diving yacht right here. I have a feeling that the sailboat gift with purchase is simply not going to float accurately. Obviously, Lego does float in itself, but will it float well is the question. And I love my sailboat gift with purchase here, this Lego Ideas. So I think we'll leave it up here. And then the other boat that we have is the wrecked shrimp boat. So, well, maybe we'll bring it down. Let's see. Never know. So we're gonna gather up these boats and we're gonna see if they actually float, because Lego does tell us that this ship is supposed to float and this catamaran is supposed to float. So the question is, how well does it float? So let's get going down to the ocean. All right, guys, we are walking down to the ocean. And when in Maine, you wear the appropriate boots for the occasion. As you can see, Mr. Bins and Bricks has on his hip waders, and little Bins and Bricks has on his sort of knee-high boots. And even Mrs. Little Bins and Bricks has on her hip waders too, which were actually my son's when he was younger, because now his feet are bigger than mine. But we have taken 3 boats. So I have the cute little diving yacht here. Mr. Bins and Bricks has the Technic catamaran, and my son has the large ocean-going vessel. So we are gonna take a walk down here. We're gonna probably have the dog helping us or not helping us, so we'll have to see about that. We are in the midst of the newest hurricane here, so although it's not affecting us up here all that much, I think that the ocean down here is a little bit rougher than it normally would be due to it. All right, let's get in position. We just came down a little pair of stairs here, set of stairs. Yeah, Roxy might make this a little bit challenging. So what do you think, Mr. Bins and Bricks? What's the plan here?
I don't know, you tell me.
All right, guys, so we're gonna have to see what the dog does. So let's
get away from like the rockiest part of the shore.
All right, so we're gonna walk down. We're gonna walk down a little bit and get away from the rockier end of the shore here. Thank you. everyone. This is the first Lego boat for the float challenge. Will it float, the ocean-going exploring vessel and rocks? All right, Liam, put it in. Oh, is the current got it? That's why we're... And does it float, guys? It looks like...
It's stuck.
It's stuck. Let's see if the... put it out a little bit.
I don't have hip waders like you guys.
All right. Well, don't go out too far. It's fine. It will float in that. Awesome. Here, take this diving yacht, buddy, and then I can watch the boat if it goes out too far.
Okay.
All right, guys. So I think it's a success. What do you think, little bins and bricks? Is it floating?
I'd say it floats.
It is floating. All right. You can see I am out in this very cold water. The boots actually help quite a bit. You want to try out the diving yacht there, bud?
What?
You want to put that one in?
Sure.
All right.
I'm not 100% sure about this one.
Well,
this
I think
one could easily sink.
It could easily sink. It is floating at the meantime. It's okay. I think they're all right for now, hon. That's awesome. All right, so we have two of the three Lego boats floating. All right, Mr. Bins and Bricks. And there it is. There is the Technic catamaran sailing along. We just actually wrapped up watching Jaws 1 and 2, so this reminds me of that. Although we should not see any sharks floating in the water here.
We have a Roxy, though.
We do have a Roxy. Luckily, Roxy doesn't worry about boats too much. So all three of these awesome Lego boats float, and they float well. Hey, Roxy girl, are you enjoying swimming? Our catamaran is beached here up on the rocks. Let's get it to float here. I really love this one. This is a fantastic one to take to the ocean and float. I mean, it is designed to float, sail away there. And we shouldn't let it go out too far, though, because I'm the one that's going to have to walk in and go get it. But if you got a beach vacation coming up, definitely grab one of these to take with you.
That's for sure.
All right, buddy, so what's your pick for the best boat that floats out of the three today?
The catamaran.
Catamaran, the Technic catamaran?
Yeah.
It has some nice features, too. You can actually move the sails around a bit. You can move the rudder. And it does a really nice job kind of floating around on the ocean, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It'd be fun to take out to a lake or a pond or a little river as well. As long as you are comfortable going in after it if you need to. And there goes Roxy girl after her stick. It's a lot easier to float the boats when she's not around. Her extra crashing through the water does help the boats gain a little water. Mr. Bins and Bricks there is dumping out the ocean vessel. So the catamaran, all in all, is absolutely the best boat to float. Alright guys, I think it is time to call the challenge good and let the boats dry out. What do you think, Mr. Bins and Bricks? Are we good?
I think we're good.
I think we're good. Alright, we're gonna gather up the pieces here. We did have a little bit of a boat crisis. This is a modular component here, so it's not held on very tightly. So that one does slide off a little bit. For the most part, it was fine until I kind of knocked it into a rock, and then we did have another small piece dislodge itself here from the I'm guessing it was right here when it took a hit against the rocks, but we are all good, and we are gonna grab our boats and we're gonna take them back up and call it a successful boat float challenge.